Scientists have 3D printed a heart for the very first time. What a breakthrough! Hello and welcome back to Inform Overload. I'm your host for this video, Rebecca Felgate, and today we are talking hearts and science, which are literally two of my favourite things. Now, before we get into this story, I want to ask you a question. If you could 3D print anything, what would you go for? Let me know in the comment section down below. I'm thinking, like, I'd absolutely 3D print food at all times. I'd be so good, like a little chef in my home. Although, would it be good? I'll reveal my thoughts on that later. Once again, do like this video and share it with a friend, and check out the links in our description box to our Inform Overload Instagram. Okay, back to the story. The first 3D printer was created using the stereolithography technique in the mid-1980s. Now, in under 40 years, we've gone from printing simple 3D objects. It seems that actually now, we've moved on to printing organs. Wow. I remember doing a Most Amazing Top 10 video in 2017 about futuristic technology coming soon, and I mentioned that actually, this was in the process. Even though I knew it was coming, I am glad that it has come now, because wow. In an absolute breakthrough in technology, researchers at Tel Aviv University in Israel have managed to print the world's first heart, like an actual heart, a 3D heart. They've done this using human cells from a patient and so-called biological materials. The heart is said to anatomically be perfect and a complete cellular match. This is absolutely game-changing for the whole organ transplantation thing. Heart disease is also one of the biggest worldwide killers, so as you can see, being able to print them is pretty key. The lead researcher, Tal Devere, made a statement about the breakthrough, saying, "People have managed to 3D print the structure of a heart in the past, but not with cells or with blood vessels. Our results demonstrate the potential of our approach for engineering, personalized tissue, and organ replacement in the future." So how though? How does a person print a heart? Well, it seems that the ink, so to speak, is made of natural sugars and proteins that can be used for printing tissue. Collagen and glycoproteins make up a printable gel. It seems that scientists have created something called the extracellular matrix. To me, I think that sounds pretty sci-fi and pretty exciting. Like, what are we even talking about here? Is this actually real life? The extracellular matrix. I mean, it sounds so futuristic, but it's here. Now, it is pretty complicated, and I can't pretend to be a trained scientist, but here is a little diagram that flows that helps you visualize the process. It really helped me see how this could be a possibility. The process begins with scientists taking fatty tissues from abdominal structures, both from humans and from pigs. Thank you, pigs. Thank you. While this is exciting, and while this does mean incredible things for the future of organ transplantation, the scientists at Tel Aviv University have made it clear that this doesn't mean that they're ready to pop the heart right in right away. It seems that while the heart that they printed is anatomically accurate and a cellular match, the test print was very, very small. So the heart they printed is around the size of a rabbit, so why did they bother? Well, first they wanted to test to see if they could actually 3D print a heart. Now they know that it is possible, but printing a human-sized heart would take a lot more resources. It would require billions of cells and a lot more money. Nonetheless, this is an important step forward. When a human-sized heart is printed, scientists preempt that they will have to teach it to pump. So yeah, we do very much have our work cut out for us, but the whole thing is very promising. So, what else can we 3D print? Food! We absolutely can do it. It is already possible. There's a shop here in Toronto that 3D prints chocolates. 3D printers are capable of creating simple dishes like pasta and pizza. A company called Foodini are creating food printers commercially, which means one day the way in which we cook, well, it might literally be at the touch of a button. Print food. Print food. To me though, I'm not sure how I feel about 3D printed food. For me, cooking, the love of it is like adding a pinch of salt here and there's something else there. I think the spontaneity of food makes it really special. And would 3D printers take out the spontaneity? I kind of think so. In Spain, architects 3D printed a bridge, which is pretty crazy. It opened in December 2016 and it, you know, is a legit bridge. Would you trust it? It's also said that 3D printers can build homes for as little as $4,000. Now, I watched an amazing video of a 3D printer creating one of these homes, and it looks a lot better than even my own little one-bed apartment. Like, for $4,000, I could own one? That's like, I don't know, yeah, under 4 months' rent. So, sign me up. Own a little 3D printed house. I love it. But the world of 3D printing does have a darker edge too, as it seems it is possible to print out weapons, for example guns and plastic bullets, which could kill people. 3D printing, have we gone too far? I don't know, I guess it's more of a localized factory kind of thing, but the fact that people can own them and print whatever, maybe there should be some restrictions there. So 3D printing organs, what do you guys think to it all? What would you print if you could print anything? Let me know in the comments section down below, and if you're joining me on the food wagon, what would you print? So I'm just gonna read some comments from a video I did earlier about a bird telling Alexa to shut up. Honestly, I was kind of here for it, because Alexa does need to shut up. Bishy Bird said, "Oh my god, I love birds. I especially love hyacinth macaws, and if I had a parrot or bird, I'd call it Honey." Cute. Sabrina Quado said, "Wow, I think that's really odd that a parrot used language to stop Alexa. Usually they just mimic words without purpose. Awesome." Okay, then we had a really concerning comment from My Flock, who said, "I had a medium sulfur crested cockatoo threaten to kill me. Why? Because I stopped rubbing his head. He told me he would kill me a total of 5 times. He said, 'Ha ha ha, I kill you.' Good times." Oh, no, like, is this real? Is this a real comment? Because if so, I would say that birds have gone too far. Ooh, I just had a really interesting thought. So if we can 3D print things like cells and hearts, do you think that one day we'll be able to 3D print life? For example, would we be able to 3D print a bird? Honestly, I think that perhaps my sci-fi brain has gone too far, but that would make for a good movie. So, Mr. Spielberg, once again, I know you're watching. 3D printing birds. Do it. Okay guys, thank you for making it to the end of the video. Do let me know all of your 3D printing thoughts and what you would print if you had one in your own home. Do leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend, and stick around for more news videos. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and I'll see you soon. Bye!